Hello children, how are you? Today we are going to learn about times. Isn't it? Time is a very precious. We should follow our times. So without time, we cannot fulfill our requirements. So we have to follow the time because we should on task. We should on our particular task means we should follow the time. Time play very important role in our life, in our task, in our work to finish it on time. Okay. So let us understand first what is clock. Okay. Look at this children. This is the picture of clock what we are using in our homes. Okay. This is the standard time. And now here, the long hand, look at this long hand arrow mark, which is known as long hand, and the short arrow is there, which is known as short hand. Okay, just you have to remember, for this purpose I have drawn this picture for you, isn't it? So this is the long hand because it is a long, and it is a short, it is known as short hand. So children, we have to know the time means we have to calculate the table 5. So 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 fours are 20, like this 5 elevens are 55. So how we have to calculate time, now you know. Okay, so the long hand is in 11 and the short hand is in below the 3, that is mean 3 past. Okay, so now what's the time now? 3:55, isn't it? Now what's the time now? 3:55. We have to calculate the table 5. One more hand is there, that is known as second hand. So I have not drawn here, that you know very well, that's why, because you are after all grade 5, isn't it? So you know the second hand, this is a long hand which shows for minute, and this is a short hand which shows for hour, and one more is a long hand which shows for second. Okay. Okay children, now you have to do this exercise, page number 73. Draw the hour hand and minute hand also and write the time. Okay. Children, you have to draw the approximate time, usually time. Okay. For example, here written, when will you get up in the morning? You have to write, just draw the approximate time. And when will you go to school? That means when will you leave to school? Okay, from your home. Even the downward exercise also you have to write. Generally, we are using 12 hours clock in our home, but 24 hours clock using in defense department, railway station or railway department, television department and internet, etc. So children, we cannot see or hear the AM or PM in any train timetable or arrival or departure announcement, because the railway station or railway department, they represents time as in 24 hours. So generally railway times are written in 4 digits. Okay, the first 2 digits, that is from the left side, okay, shows the hour, and the last 2 digits from the right side show the minutes, isn't it? Look at the 24 hours clock in your textbook. It will help you to understand 24 hours clock easily. Which are railway department and another department are also using. Children, this is 24 hours clock picture here. Okay, now look it here. Generally in railway department, times are written in 4 digits. Look at here, left side shows hour and right side shows minute. So here 8:42 hours. For example, I have written this one 10 hours. Okay. And one exercise is here, we can write. Now let us see houses. In our houses, noon, that is mean afternoon, 12 o'clock. But in the railway department, written like this, 12 hours. 1 p.m. means in railway department, 13 hours. Because after 12, it becomes 13. Okay. Now, 9 a.m. means 9 o'clock. And midnight, okay, when we are sleeping, okay, at that time 12 o'clock means 12 o'clock or 24 hours. We can write in this way in the railway department, isn't it? Now, here in the morning, while 1 o'clock night, midnight, in that time, for example, Monday is started, okay. 1 o'clock Monday night when we are sleeping night, Monday morning AM, okay, AM means morning, PM means evening, so AM means anti-meridian, PM means post-meridian, that you will study in higher grades, okay, that you, now you have to study AM, that is Monday morning 1 o'clock when we are sleeping, night for us 1 o'clock for us night we are sleeping, but for the railway department it is 13, okay. Monday means in the railway department also Monday means 1 o'clock, that is mean morning, it's going to start morning, so morning 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, like 5 o'clock, 5 o'clock we wake up and we are coming to school, and then afternoon 12 o'clock still we are in school, okay, then again in the railway department not 1 o'clock, after 12, it is become 13, okay, it is become 13, but for us, it is become 1 o'clock, that is PM, for us, it becomes PM, for railway department, it is same, like 12 o'clock, like 13 o'clock, okay, 13, then 14, 15, 16, like that only, it is all Monday, it's coming Monday, okay, then again, it is evening Monday. Now 6 o'clock is a evening Monday. Now 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock is a evening Monday. Now 10 o'clock is a night Monday. So that is in railway department 22 o'clock. Okay, 22nd o'clock. Then it is 12 o'clock. For us it is 12 o'clock we are sleeping. But for the railway department the one day is over. So 24 o'clock. That is mean one day is over. Now 12:05 means, that is 1 o'clock mean Tuesday started. Okay. Understood children? 1 o'clock here. For us it is the same 1 o'clock night only. But for railway department it is 1 o'clock Tuesday. That is morning it is. Okay. Now you have seen this all pictures. I hope you would have understood clearly. A important point have to be noted. While converting the 12-hour time to 24 hour time during PM, we should add 12. Okay, children, we should add 12 to hours and keep the minute same. What does it mean? It means, see, now in the afternoon when it is 12 for us, railway department also 12, but for us 1 o'clock it become PM, but for railway department it's same 13 o'clock. How it's possible? They are adding 12 plus 1, 13. Okay, 13 hours. Then again 12 plus 2, 14 hours. So 12 plus 3, 15 hours. Isn't it? Like that, it's going to become 24 hours. Okay. Okay, understand children? I have explained these questions just now. You can copy this in your notebook.